Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you DJ ESG.
What's up, guys? DJ ESG, season number 12, Honest Wedding Advice. And today I'm talking about the backup wedding dress. Yes, out of my last 10 brides, three of them had a massive dress issue, like into the dancing portion of it. And it was terrible because one of the dresses broke. Another bustle fell off, bead or whatever you call those things, button. And then something just happened totally where one of the seams got ripped out. So I had three out of my last 10 brides have a massive dress problem where they were trying to have a good time and it hindered their good time during the dancing. Now, dress, awesome. Dresses are great, man. Dressmakers, seamstresses, everybody that's involved in the dress process, they love what they do and they want to see you look good. Come down the aisle, get married, get your pictures, have your first dance. After that's done, man, you want to party. You don't want to worry about fixing or holding up your dress or going in the hallway and missing your song. I had a bride miss the most important song to her of that evening. Now, granted, I had 200 and some people there. I saw her from where I was standing. It was like across the room, but I didn't know she was getting her dress fixed. I couldn't see that. I'm not going to jump out of the back of the DJ booth every 5 seconds to make sure that, you know, she's good. She's good. French. She's good. She's good to go. You know, I see her in the room. My job is to make sure that she's there. Okay. Once I know that she's there or he's there, the groom or the couple, then I got to play that song or I'm able to then play the must play song. It's not my job to go over there and be like, are you okay? Do you feel good? Does your head hurt? Did your stomach hurt? Is your dress fixed? Do your shoes work? Do you have, you know, are your heels still up? Do you need the bathroom? Like, that's not my job. Job is to make sure that she's there in the room. Now I'm playing your song, the song that you wanted me to play. So I start playing the song and I look up and everybody's jamming and she gives me this look from like across the dance floor, but I didn't know she was looking at me. And then she starts like fiddling behind her and I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, cause like I was going to the next song. I was like, okay, she's there. She heard it. She gets it. Like her face was like that. And I was like, okay, so she knows, you know. Lo and behold, they're behind her fixing her dress because her fucking bustle fell apart and she missed her song. So they walk up to me. They go, can you do that again? I'm like, I guess. Sure, we'll play it again. You know, I waited till the very end to play it again so it wasn't like back to back. But, you know, and the whole night she was fixing her dress. And I was like, man, I felt so bad. We had to like tie it up because somebody stepped on it and it pulled. And I was like, man. And she was sort of upset because she wanted to dance and she couldn't really dance. Another one lost a button and another one, it was just like it wasn't made to be bustled. It was just sort of laying on the ground. She had one of those things that go through your wrist and you hold it up the whole time. And she was trying to drink and dance and it was just a pain in the ass. So I had another bride recently that had a dress change. Now, the dress that she wore was beautiful. And then the dress that she changed into was shorter. I mean, it was like knee high. So there was no way of tripping over it. I mean, it was white, but she got changed, came back, and she had a blast. I mean, she had such a good time. Now, I know it's a little bit more money. I know it's a little bit more of an expense, but you don't have to literally put that on top of an expense. You can take something that's like, this is not so important or not so relevant. And, we'll exchange this for this so that that the bride's comfortable. Groom doesn't matter. He takes off, you know, if he breaks a belt, he gets another belt. If he splits his pants, oh well. You know, if he takes off his jacket and shirt comes out, it is what it is. But, you know, you're not bustling a groom's, you know, whatever you call this down here, his fucking hem. Like, you're not grabbing on the hem and pulling it up, you know, and making sure the pants aren't, you know, long enough. The pants are going to be long regardless. If you lose your belt or start dropping your pants or sweating or you have no ass or it's flat, they're going to sag down. You step all over them like a kid back in fucking high school when he was wearing JNCOs, when it was cool to step all over your pants. Whole different story. But I'm telling you, as a bride, you don't want to have that issue happen. So if you want to make sure that that dress is, you know, multi-bustle dress, or you don't have a sleek thing with like one bustle that pulls it up and it's just straight around, or like you don't have the perfect body and you have to have a certain kind of dress made where it's a big princess dress and there's a lot going on, you know, you might want to think about having a secondary option so you can dance and have a good time. I mean, if you go to the after party anyway, you're going to say, oh, I'm going to go home and get changed and put on something more comfortable. What if you just went to the after party wearing what you were wearing? Now you have to worry about it. You know what I mean? Just go right there. So you look at it from this perspective. I tell everybody to have two dresses, to have dress A, which is the nice dress for everything you're going to be doing, the pictures, the formalities, and then have a change dress where you can go upstairs during dinner time, put this dress on and then dance in it for 2.5 hours. Not have to worry about it touching the ground or falling over shit. And you can have a blast and have a good time at your wedding. Listen, Some people have thought about it. Some people have done it. Some people haven't done it. I'm telling you, seamstresses are great, but they're not expecting people to pull or tug or step on it. Or shit does happen. You know what I mean? Like, I had a $200 pair of cowboy boots one time, and I was dancing, and all of a sudden, I mean, cowboy boots cost anywhere between, you know, $200 and $10,000. And, like, the boot ripped, and I'm sitting there doing the party, and the fucking boot's like this in the front. I'm looking at that, and my toes hanging out. Luckily, I got nice feet. You know what I mean? So I had to worry about that shit. But, you know, it is what it is. It's great advice. Take it or leave it. I'm DJ ESG. Peace, love, and God above, and I'm out. Bye-bye.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? I went to a shrink to analyze my dreams. She says it's like a sex that's bringing me. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm